Just the other day, I was working on the XFC Wayland video and came across this note. Workspace support is missing. EXT Workspace Protocol was just merged. This is a protocol that I not only didn't know was being worked on, I didn't know even existed in the first place. And this is an issue that I have discussed, maybe not every single occasion I can, but enough that I remember the times that I've talked about this. Why is it that there wasn't a standardized way to report workspace information under Wayland? The name, the number, the creation, the activation, all the very important things you need to know to build things like status bars and control your workspaces and things like that. Now, it may not be the case for the embedded Wayland compositors, things like Cage, a kiosk compositor intended for things like signboards, or GameScope, which is for desktop use, but is intended to run a single application at a time. But when we're talking about the general desktop Wayland compositors, whether that's in a desktop environment like GNOME, KDE, Cosmic, whether it's a standalone wind manager like Hyperland, Sway, River, almost every single desktop compositor today has workspace support, even if you as a user don't actually use it. Basically everything has support for it. I'm sure there's something that doesn't, but none of the big options have that issue. So the fact that this even needed to be a protocol discussion and not just like a core part of Wayland from the very start of the project completely baffles me, because even back when Wayland was getting started, workspaces already existed. They were a thing that people used under X11. They were a thing back in the 90s. How is this a new protocol? I don't understand. And now this protocol has been dealt with. This has now been merged into the upstream Wayland protocols repo. Now, as with many of the very long-running and very sensible Wayland protocol extensions that should not be extensions, they should have been part of the core Wayland spec from the very start, this discussion didn't actually start within the upstream project. It started over in WL Roots, over in the WLR protocols repo. Now, at the time, this was not archived. Back then, a lot of extensions were being done here, and then eventually they were being moved into the upstream repo. Since then, though, WL Roots has moved into doing everything upstream, which frankly has slowed a lot of things down, and I really wish they kept going with the downstream protocol repo like they had before. But this merge request is not the first mention of the protocol. This actually stemmed from an earlier issue, that being on April 11th, 2018, Virtual Desktop Protocol. Now, when we talk about virtual desktops and virtual workspaces, technically there are two different paradigms, but people often use the words interchangeably, so it's kind of hard to know what someone is actually talking about. One is the way that i3 does it, where you have individual workspaces for each of your monitors. So if you change the workspace on monitor 1, the workspace on monitor 2, that does not change. So it's completely independent. Now, when we're talking about desktop environments like GNOME and KDE, these have a connected system where if you change the workspace on one monitor, every single workspace changes at the same time. I have an extreme preference to each monitor having their own individual workspaces. It makes things for me considerably easier. I can change the workspace on monitor 1, have my OBS still open, have notes if I'm streaming, have my chat open, and I don't have to do any weird stuff with like sticky windows, which ignores workspace changes. I can just use it the way that I want to use it. However, I understand that users might like both approaches, and both are things that should be supported. The goal of this protocol is to support out-of-process bars that can be run on any window manager. Think things like Polybar. I don't know why he's saying this was never possible on X11, because it was very possible, and people do it every day, and people are doing it literally at this very moment. I don't really know what he means by this. Putting that aside, this is a problem that you may have dealt with if you tried to find a status bar under Wayland, because a lot of them only support a specific desktop. They'll work on Sway, they'll work on Hyperland, they'll work on River, But because different desktops provide different ways of reporting the workspace they're currently on, there was no good consistent way to just make something work on everything and you say, okay, support the workspace protocol, give me the information about the workspaces. That just wasn't a thing. Required of the protocol, list all of the workspaces for each output. So you know, okay, these workspaces are on monitor one, these are on monitor two, these are on monitor three, so on and so forth. And if you're doing something like GNOME, it's just going to say the exact same workspaces for every single output. A way to request a change in the active workspace or create a new workspace. And three, workspaces on multiple outputs at once. So again, that is the GNOME approach that everything is just the same workspace. Now, whilst the actual protocol implemented over here stemmed from this issue, this is not the first time the issue has been discussed in a different context. Going back even further, here is a discussion from 2016 in the KDE project. Virtual Desktop Protocol. A dedicated protocol is needed to announce the virtual desktops K1 is using and Plasma Window need to expose the virtual desktop. The virtual desktop interface should not expose too much implementation detail. It should be more than a number. A possibility might be to use a DBus interface instead of a Wayland interface. Now, at the time, there was, I guess, a lot less cooperation on extensions, so KDE went down their own route, GNOME went down their route, WRoots went down their route, and we kind of just were in this situation where workspaces were a thing that worked, but there was no compatible implementation functional across everything. If you wanted to support different things, you would need to go and write for the specific desktop you actually want to support. After about a year of talking things out, trying to work out what issues this has and what it should address and things like that, that is when the XML protocol was actually made. This is the formalization of what the protocol should be doing. But this was not the implementation of the actual protocol. That came a little bit later over in the WRoots repo in 2020. Don't merge. WLR workspaces implementation. This was very much a work in progress. It was a proof of concept, but it was something. Now, this was the library implementation. There also needs to be an implementation over in a compositor that was actually using it. And here is one over in Wayfire. Wayfire, for anyone who doesn't know, is basically a spiritual successor to things like Compiz. There's a bunch of nice fancy effects like burning windows and the cube and things like that. Back then, there weren't as many of those in KDE. Nowadays, you know, KDE does the ones that most people care about, but Wayfire still has a bunch of extra really weird ones. Now, eventually, both WLR protocols and WRoots moved over to GitLab, and with that, all of the issues that were made there also moved over. I don't know why that... Moving on from that, now whilst some discussion was still had in both these merge requests, as you can see, this one has been closed and this one remains open. Because before things moved over in this right here, there was an upstream issue also made, that being the one I showed you at the start of the video. This is the state things were in about 4 years ago with its original maintainer, Ilya Bozhinov. This is an updated version of the WLR Workspace Unstable V1 protocol, original work from that issue we saw just before. The intention of the protocol is to expose information about workspaces in the compositor and associate them with outputs. A compositor exposes one or more workspace groups. Each workspace group is comprised of several workspaces. Each workspace group is visible on a few outputs. For example, in Wayfire, there is one workspace group per output because the workspaces on each output are independent. This is the same way that it'll work on i3 or Sway. This is the same way it works on things like Hyperland. And then in GNOME, probably also KDE, one would probably also have a workspace group per output. And all of them except the primary output's workspace will just have one workspace. Clients would be able to use this protocol to implement workspace switching widgets in panels, command line tools used to focus a workspace, and similar. So you could have a generic status bar or a generic tool for changing the workspaces. No more on KDE. If you want to do things from the command line, dealing with this DBus interface, there is a way you can actually do it from the command line. It's this like 30 character long command. It's annoying. You can do it, but like, I never remember it. I always have to like look it up. Now, if you've been here for the Wayland Protocol discussions before, you probably know exactly where this is going to go next. Many of the protocols of the time looked like relatively good protocols, and initially, there was some interest in getting it done. There was some interest in working on things and fixing issues, and then there was a couple of comments, and this started, remember, 4 years ago. This is where we hit 2 years ago. There's maybe like 12 comments before things completely stall. And I know that I like to talk about Cosmic a lot, but Victoria Breckenfield and the Cosmic Desktop revived this protocol discussion. Without Cosmic, this probably would have never happened. I am currently working on the implementation of this protocol for Cosmic Comp, the Cosmic Compositor, and found some unclear parts of the documentation going into a bunch of things that still need to be dealt with. Now, like with WL Roots, Cosmic also has their own protocols repo, and there are some things in here which they do vendor because they just want things to be there and they want things to be stable even though they're technically not yet ready. The goal of this protocol repo though is to have nothing in it. If it doesn't need to be there specifically for Cosmic, eventually it should be upstreamed, but having it in a downstream repo like this makes it easier to iterate on things, makes it easier to implement something that actually works today, and it's a good idea to have it. Now, the reason why I say Victoria is very important to reviving this protocol is the original author did stick around for a little bit, was answering some queries, was trying to like, you know, improve things, but it's clear they just didn't really have that much time to work on the protocol, and if they were leading it, maybe it would get done eventually, but like, it wouldn't be anytime soon. So since Cosmic wanted the protocol and the original author just didn't have time to work on it, Victoria just basically took over the protocol and just started answering a lot of questions, started fixing a lot of issues, and it started making a lot of progress very quickly. And as of about 7 months ago, we got this comment. Hi, what's the status of this merge request? It seems to have stalled for some reason. Now, it technically did stall for about 5 months or so, but like that's not that big in the case of Wayland, right? Things stall for a lot longer in the world of Wayland. The status is the same as it was months ago. We have a mostly feature complete protocol draft that might need a couple of touch-ups now, addressing some minor comments and a rebase, but essentially needs acts and implementations for further evaluation. So acts are where a desktop or a project acknowledges the protocol and says, okay, we are good to have this, and then implementations are implementations. The reason it is stalled has nothing to do with the protocol itself, but with how busy all participants are. There are actionable items on the table, mostly implementations. What this merge request needs is simply people taking on these tasks and driving things forward. And with that, we got an implementation over on the XFCE side. Yes, XFCE is still very far away from fully supporting Wayland, but they are eventually going to be there, and this is still a start. From there were still some minor issues to address, and thankfully, most of them didn't require giant threads to resolve. The longest one here is 6 comments, which for Wayland is a very quiet day. Usually things are like, let's just argue for like 50 comments. And it seems like they pretty much just agree like, yeah, you know what? Maybe that's a good idea. Maybe we should do that. Imagine this, Wayland, where people are agreeing on things and progress is being made. What a crazy world we live in. And as of about 4 months ago, this is all of the implementations we currently had. Weebar, libxfce for windowing, which is the windowing library being used over an XFCE to abstract out the X11 and Wayland stuff so they can just write a thing that calls the library rather than having specific things in every single application. WL Roots, Cosmic Comp, LabWC, and SFWBar. These three here were using the Cosmic version of the protocol, the one they had vendored over in their repo. Some of them are quite dated or use a vendored edition, but allegedly updating to match the current state of the protocol shouldn't be too difficult. Given this situation, do I understand correctly that what's left is to resolve the remaining minor issues and get Axe? Pretty much that's all was left. At this point, there was plenty of implementations. You could have more, but you don't need any more. With some further issues being resolved, all that was left now was to ack it. So they basically already had the cosmic ack because Victoria is the voting member for that project, but they need some other people to actually get involved. So Victoria reached out to people who had expressed at least some sort of interest in this protocol existing. Immersion, Blackbone, which are both of the Simons from W Roots, and David Edmondson and Zzag, otherwise known as Vlad from KDE. And David was the first person to chime in. From a KDE point of view, we're not in a huge rush to implement it, though we would consider it in the future. That said, it's clear you have enough valid implementations effectively using it already. It's better for everyone to have it in a centralized place in EXT. Ack from KDE. So KDE being a desktop where they have their own bar, you know, it's not super important to have this functionality in KDE. But KDE is very open to people doing customization, and I would hope at some point in the future, this is something they do go and implement. And following that, we got someone who hadn't been in the thread at all at this point, Christopher James Halls Rogers from the MIR project, or MIR project, however you want to say it, who had some very minor issues to be resolved, but besides that, was more than happy to ack it. So at this point, they have way more than their three implementations, and they have all three of their acks from MIR, KDE, and Cosmic. It would have been nice to have W Roots, considering this started as a W Roots project. I don't entirely know why that never actually happened. Maybe, I don't know, Simon, both Simons were busy, but like, being from W Roots, it logically would make sense to ack it there. I don't see any reason why you wouldn't. Regardless, at this point, the protocol was basically done. Technically, it was complete. There was still one more thing to do, and that is the final review. At this point, it's basically just dealing with grammatical issues and spelling issues and formatting issues and things like that. Things that don't really change the core functionality of the protocol. It's like, it should be fixed, but it's just documentation issues. Like, hey, why is there a random space here? Why is this word used instead of this word? Things like that. And as of November 11th, Xavier Hugel signed off on the review. So at this point, it's pretty much just done. Unless somebody has an objection, unless there is some reason it shouldn't be merged, now it's just a matter of actually going and doing so. First, everything was squashed down, all the threads resolved, all the additional issues that people might have had were dealt with, and then, as of 6 days ago, the protocol was actually merged. Now again, keep in mind that KDE, whilst they don't have an implementation yet, are at least interested in discussing the protocol and maybe implementing it sometime in the future. GNOME is absolutely nowhere to be seen in the entire discussion, so do not hold your breath for that actually being implemented there. But when we talk about Cosmic, MIR, and W Roots, and then hopefully KDE, they are going to have support for this protocol, so status bars are going to work a whole lot better. It'll take some time to get the implementations finished up and merged, but hopefully sometime next year, we start seeing some really cool cross-desktop status bars. But what do you think? Do you think this protocol mattered full stop? Do you care about your workspaces being shown in your status bar? I'd love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to the BearerPay link in the description down below. And if you have any other ideas for how this could be used, maybe like a overlay or something else like that, I'd love to know. So that's going to be it for me, and let's just do the old outro. I'm out.